Blog Talk Radio.
I'm on an airplane, and the destination of the flight is to the other side. Guess I had to go there. Guess I had to come here, yeah. I know where I'm from, but now I'm headed where I'm going, right? But there are powers in the air, you can't see them. And they have rockets and machine guns, and they're firing on my plane. But I say fire,
listening to Spate Radio. We will have Mali Music in the building today. He will be talking about his latest single, Ready Aim, which we were just playing just now. It's a dope single. We have someone on the line right now, 917. Who's there? 917. Hello? Hello? 917? All right, we're going to put you on hold. We're going to get back into this.
I'm on an airplane, and the destination of this flight is to the other side.
917? Hello? Hello? You on the air? Hello?
I'm on an airplane, and the destination of this flight is to the other side. Guess I had to go there. Guess I had to come here.
917, you on the line. Who's there?
Hey, Antoine, it's Brandy. I have Mali Music for you.
Great.
You ready?
Yep, ready.
Hold on 1 second. Mm-hmm. Mali?
I'm here.
You're on with Antoine King.
What's going on, boss?
Hey, what's good, man?
How's everything going?
And everything is good. It's a beautiful day out here in Cali. I'm enjoying it.
That's what's up. You're out there in Cali. For the people that don't know, can you maybe introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about the style of music that you do?
Yeah. Well, hey, everybody, what's going on? I'm Mali Music. I'm from Savannah, Georgia. And the style of music that I do is extremely inspirational. My backing is heavily gospel, so I'm always trying to do things and create music and sounds and vibes that will inspire, you know what I'm saying, invoke and expose, like, higher identity and just something to bring comfort in a world where tragedy is prominent. And but at the same time, I wanted to feel good doing it, so I got a lot of soul influences, a whole lot of hip-hop, also a lot of gospel influences as far as, like, my harmonies and my content, and I think it's just a beautiful package.
Okay, that's what's
in
up.
In a nutshell, Mali Music.
Nice, nice. So tell us a little bit about your journey and how you came to this point of working with Grammy-winning artists and stuff like that. So maybe how did you get the attention of, like, the entertainment executives to bring you to this point right now?
Yeah, well, one thing I could definitely say that I'm sure of is, like, this is just supposed to happen. It's, like, kind of one of those, like, divine intervention type things. Because
uh-huh.
a lot of it I can't even explain. But just, you know, Country Boy back in Georgia, love music. Was doing music my whole life, especially singing or whatever in the church. Didn't have a lot of, like, backing. Wasn't, like, an organ player, nothing I looked up to. So my own creativity was all I had. So I'm singing songs. I had Pro Tools, keyboard, guitar, doing all this music like that. So the main outlet, the biggest outlet to living and surviving was writing songs. So I wrote my first song when I was six. What does a six-year-old got to sing about? You know, so that's when I learned. That's where I found my voice. So I knew writing songs was a big part of it. Then I just became a bit of a storyteller. That kind of grew up, making a long story short. We did a concert. I'm in Savannah, Georgia for my first release, which was The Coming, like an EP before my first album, The Second Coming, and it blew up like crazy. It had songs in there like I Hate You, All I Have to Give Forward, No Music, which is stuff that my fan base right now knows about. That kind of blew up. We moved over to Los Angeles. I moved over to California, which was Fresno, and did a showcase with who's my co-manager now, Holly Carter. It's a big
okay.
showcase. Merge Conference, I did that. Music Matters was doing it. That's when I met Kelly G. They loved it. And then Robbie Reed at BET was a big fan, so I started linking with them. And then that's when I had to do this big showcase in New York. Killed. It was amazing. And from that, I had opportunity to sing on the BET Awards. When I did the BET stage, everything just blew open. The next day, I was rocking with Khan, and the rest is history.
Wow, so it does sound like it was meant to happen.
Yeah, dude. It just was supposed to happen, dude. Savannah, Georgia, whatever.
You can't plan all that.
No, not at all, man. All you can do is just be ready, have good songs, and, you know, give it when they give you a mic.
That's what's up, man. Definitely. So the single that you have, this is your debut single on a major, right? Correct?
Yes.
Ready, Aim. Tell us about that, like, who produced it, who wrote it, and, you know, the idea around the whole song.
Yeah, definitely. Ready, Aim is just, I love that song. It's amazing. And I don't think it will ever be a point in my life where it's, like, irrelevant, like the message doesn't apply to me. Like I say all the time concerning the song, whenever you come in contact or in line with your purpose or your destiny, like when you're not beating around the bush, when you get in that scene that you like, that you're giving breath for, like it's so much random resistance that comes, whether it's from people, whether it's from what people like to call haters. On top of that, there's all these other principalities that fight, just bad things just happening, just trying to distract you and get you off base.
Mm-hmm.
So what I was doing, I was saying, since I'm locked in, I know due to the opposition and the resistance that I must be on the right lane. So I'm not going to let nothing move me off of this path. So whatever you got to do, do it. Ready, aim, fire, you can't shoot me down.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a crazy idea that I had in the studio when I was in New York with Jerry Wanda at Platinum Sound. So
mm-hmm.
Jerry is like just a dream collaboration for me. And before that, I was doing on my own production, on my own engineering. So when I signed with RCA, I said, Mark, I want all the benefits of a major label. I want all the producers, I want all the writers, I want the big studios, I want it all, you know. So they kind of laughed, but they made it happen, and that's when I linked up with Jerry Wanda. He produced Going Till November, stuff with the Fugees. I mean, he's just amazing. His catalog is nuts. But, you know, I come in with my weird ideas, and just really we just stretched each other, and next thing you know, Ready Aim was born. I wrote it, it was already in my heart. Fire, you can't shoot me down.
Definitely. That's definitely a dope record, and it has a great message. And what I like about your sound is it's kind of like a reggae, R&B type, you know, and then it has like a positive, like, gospel message to it. So,
yeah.
Like, was this all planned, or was kind of just something that was inside of you?
Well, I can't say that my style is planned, but, like, everywhere I go, everybody's like, are you Jamaican or you gotta be from the West Indies or whatever like that? It's just this twang that I have. I have no idea where it came from.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, you got that plus the tone. So I think just the feel of it is so different. It's so absolutely me, which is like what I was saying the key was early on. My musical foundation is me as far as like my own creative vibe. I couldn't listen to a lot of music, so all I could do was sing and make music, and that's just how it came out. So, I mean, I know how to do me well, and I'm grateful to God for that. So I think that combination with confidence, good content, and just wonderful music can't fail, you know?
Yeah, yeah, okay. That sounds about right there. As far as like as far as songs like for an album, like are you working on the album, or do you have idea as far as when that's gonna come?
Oh, definitely, man. Well, like I said earlier, I write to live, so
okay.
I think my song catalog is close to 700-800 songs, and maybe
wow.
over 1,000. Fragments of songs, so like songs isn't even the problem. It's just all about I'm really dedicated to creating and putting out a body of work, you know?
Okay.
Not just a lot of songs, 10 or 11 songs with 3 or 4 good ones, so like a lot of people do now. Like, I want to return and continue to assist, because I believe that Justin Timberlake just did it. He just released a body of work, and like, it was so refreshing to all the music lovers. And,
exactly.
So I just want to continue to do that. And so, yeah, we're looking to do an EP. I'm kind of fighting against it, only because I'm ready for everybody to get the album. But
okay.
Molly is coming soon. The EP is looking to drop in June, maybe
okay.
the top of July, into June.
Mm-hmm.
And the album is going to be dropping at the top of the year, if not the end of the year, so December, January. But I'm just
okay.
fighting for it to already drop. I'm trying to get y'all music.
Yes, definitely, definitely. We want to definitely cop that album. So as far as, like, any, besides singing, do you play any instruments or anything like that?
Yeah, keyboard, guitar, whatever I need to get the sound I want.
Okay. Okay, and a lot of artists nowadays are choosing to go the indie route because you have so much, like, YouTube, and you have Facebook. You have so many different ways to promote an indie artist. You choosing a major at this point, do you feel like indie is something you didn't want to do, or
no, not at all? It's I don't know. It was the way that the deal was made.
Okay.
You know, like, it's not anything that was just, oh yeah, I'm excited, I want to do this, da da da. It wasn't like that. It's perfect for what it is I'm trying to do. RCA and Botchstorm understood where I was going,
mm-hmm.
understood the, you know, how necessary it was for me to remain in creative control of what was going on. I respect Mark Pitts as an artist developer. It was
mm-hmm.
just all these things. It was just the perfect situation. But it was many years and many deals and, you know, contracts later that, you know, this one actually came, and actually
mm-hmm.
came due to the work that I did as an indie.
Okay.
So, yeah, like, I'm grateful for all the love, like, accumulated hundreds of thousands of devout Molly Music fans independent. But with what I want to present and the things that I see, I know that without a label, I don't have the budget, the button, the power, or the machine to put out the quality of production that I desire to put out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, music is good, but there's so many other things that affects music. You got, like, stage, lights, you know, stage production, show production, videos, pictures, all that stuff. So a lot of times the thing they don't tell us about indie is cool when you can do some stuff on YouTube, but, you know what I'm saying, websites, they cost every month. You know what I'm
yeah.
saying? Radio
yeah.
people cost every month. Managers,
yeah.
they cost every month. And
yeah.
it's coming out of your pocket. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, definitely.
Just sold a couple of hundred albums at a show, and all of it's gone because you had to pay for your travel, your hotel stay, you had to fly your band, you had to pay
yeah.
your manager that month, you had to
yeah.
do all this, and all that's coming
yeah.
out of the same pot. So just based on where I wanted to go and to get that boost, and also to learn a lot more about the industry itself, I
yeah.
think that the only way to get to a point to where I understand how it truly works is to experience both sides. And I was independent for 9, almost 10 years.
Wow.
I'm on this deal right now, the RCA, I'm enjoying it. And now, after all of it is said and done, I think I'm going to be a monster of a businessman, and I'll have a lot of, like, mental nuggets and wisdom to give to people in the future, you know what I'm saying, about which way is the best way to go.
Great. That's phenomenal right there. That's so, you know, to all the indie artists that are listening that are actually doing what you did already, you know, as far as the grind, uh-huh. they can take what you just said and really absorb it and make those similar decisions and stuff like that.
Yeah. The truth of it, you can only take yourself so far. And I think I got as far as I could get alone. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
a lot of followers, and that right there will be your pull. So you get a lot of followers on Twitter, a lot of Facebook friends, and you also have a devout fan base, you'll be able to have more freedom at a label. But if you don't have anything to show for your art and you want the label to do all the work, it probably won't get done. So it's because I kind of bring the best of both worlds. I already know how to run my machine, so when you sign with a label, you get access to a lot of budgets that you wouldn't have been able to, a lot of people who believe in you, and you get a lot of more bigger opportunities that you don't have to pay for. It's awesome.
Definitely. That's what's up, man. Like, now that you're, you know, signed to a major and you're in a much bigger spotlight, you know, like the cameras are on and your business, your personal business, everything is out on the table. So now you have, you know, Facebook and Twitter. Do you feel like Facebook and Twitter is too much? Because now people are going to see you on television and stuff like that. So do you feel like the technology, like Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, do you feel like that can be a bit much for artists?
It can be much for a certain type of artist. Like, there's a type of artist who will thrive off of it because they are probably like an artist / model or an artist / whatever. You know what I mean? Like, you have to be a certain type of person to enjoy social media anyway. There's a certain level of attention or a certain level of, you know, news that you want to get. But I'm very personal and extremely selective about what I allow to enter into my space. So I could be in a great mood when I wake up, go on Twitter, see one of my friends post something that happened to them. Now I'm sad. You know what I'm saying? From something that no one even brought into my space. You get what I'm saying?
Exactly.
But the only reason that matters as much as it does to me is because I create out of the same heart. So I don't just, like, give it to everything. Or, you know, a lot of people aren't creating. They're just listening so they can afford to do it. But, you know, I got a call to, you know, do it. And you want restaurants to be very big on their hygiene. You don't want them letting anything and everybody cook for you. But you want it to be healthy. So, like, I just kind of respect myself as a business and an outlet. But it could get a little overwhelming because I'm extremely private.
Yeah.
And so I'm extremely transparent in my music. That's the way that I chose to expose myself. So, but it can never hurt. I also feel that there's a level of, like, mystique that artists should have and used to have that people really enjoyed. But now you never know what's going on. I don't ever meet a stranger anymore, and that kind of makes me uncomfortable sometimes. It's like, hey, Molly. I'm like, hey.
Like, I don't really know you.
I tweeted you every day last week. You know what I'm saying? You ain't replying nothing, but I know you saw him. So, man, I just love your music. I'm like, yeah, so what's your name? What happened to people introducing themselves? Like, what's your name? Not at whatever. But, yeah, so. It's really good, and I'm a bit old school. You know, I learned that. I found that out about myself, but I appreciate everything that social media has done for my brand. It's amazing, and the Molly Music sound. So, you know, there's ups and downs, but that's how it goes with anything.
Okay. All right. That's what's up, man. So I really like the song that you have with Lecrae. How did you connect with Lecrae and make that happen?
Well, it was actually really cool. I got a call from Rudy Currents, who's a crazy talented guy out of Atlanta now, and he's out of Carolina. But he was working with Lecrae on it, and they were writing some hooks. And they reached out and was like, yo, you know, we want you to do a hook. So they sent the reference or whatever, and I was like, yo, this is crazy. But after I listened to it a couple of times, I had a whole, like, different idea. So I laid that down and sent it back, and they were like, oh, man. So Craig was like, oh, I got to go back to the boy. And he went back, and he put it down, and history was made. While we were shooting the video, we connected like crazy, and it was just awesome. And we're kind of doing like the same thing. He's like a really commend him on everything that he's doing in hip hop, you know, what I'm saying, through the lens of gospel and like devout Christianity and content like that. Like, that's amazing, like the barriers that he's breaking. So, like, you know, it's awesome to be able to team up with somebody who's, you know, having success on their field. And it's great to be able to work with people who are, you know, equally successful, equally talented, and equally secure. And I think that that's just a winning formula for a banger.
Definitely, definitely. That's so you worked with him. You did, y'all guys did that song before the Grammy, right?
Yeah, long before the Grammys.
Yeah, that was and I think us the video, the song was released last year, right? In 2012.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So wow, and well, how did you feel when you heard about the Grammy since you guys did a song together and everything?
Well, hey, it was awesome, and I was extremely like proud of him, but I mean, Until the World is dope, but man, I don't think that he got the Grammy because Until the World, like, Lecrae is dope. That was long overdue, so I just really celebrated him. I didn't take any credit for that, you know what I mean? It was his moment. Gravity won it. To God be the glory. I'm excited, and I'm ready to get mine too, though.
You're next, right?
Yes, sir.
That's what's up, man. So, as far as like an artist that out there right now that you would like to work with, is there anybody else on the table like that you would be interested in working with that you haven't done yet?
Oh, most definitely. I say it all the time, like, my dream collaboration is with CeeLo.
Okay.
I really love what he brings to the table, and he's extremely conscious. Like, he's extremely like aware and alert. I believe that the company or the people might not really want that version of him, but I would love to kind of reawake that one. I was a big fan of, like, Goody Mob early when I was really young, especially in that, you know, Savannah and Georgia.
Mm-hmm.
So I loved what he was doing with them. And I also would love to do some music and break bread with Lauryn Hill.
Okay.
She was doing some groundbreaking stuff with, like, the Miseducation. And, you know, things happen. And the way that she chose to go, like, as far as away from music and doing what she's doing with her family, I'm very curious of the hundreds of songs that we've never heard that's in her belly, you know? So I would like to juice her for all of those and say, I'll do it. So, yeah, it's a lot of people that I'm excited to work with, but just definitely everyone who's bringing change and affecting the world in a real way.
Okay. All right. We're running out of time, but I did want to touch on the Essence Festival a little bit. Maybe you can tell the people, when is it actually?
Man, I have no idea. June. I don't know. I'm not even the one to talk to about, like, dates.
Oh, okay.
Because,
all
like,
right. So, but you're performing there. The important part is you're performing there. Right?
Right. Yeah, I'll be performing at the Essence Festival this year.
Okay. All right. So, your fans could definitely check you out. Are there any other dates that might be notable, or any other places that you may be performing that the people can check you out?
Oh, yeah. If they're listening to this now, I'm going to be in North Carolina on Friday, and I'm going to be in Jacksonville on Saturday. So, SCC, you know what I'm saying, come out. And, you know, it'd be good to be close to home. And, you know, definitely those. But besides that, definitely prepare for Essence because it's going to be amazing.
Yeah, I know. It sounds like you got something planned for them for that.
Oh, my God. I do, bro. I really do. You can't give people like me opportunities like that and not expect us to go off. we're man. And it's just a really good time. And it's a stage that I never would have got. And it's a, you know, great opportunity. And so I'm excited, man.
That's what's up, man. So tell the people where they can find you as far as, like, website, Twitter, Facebook, and stuff like that.
Yeah, please, everyone, follow me on Twitter at Molly Music, MALIMUSIC, no spaces. Same thing on Facebook, facebook.com/MollyMusic. Also, subscribe to my newsletter on my website, mollymusicnote.com, and we'll keep you guys abreast on everything that'll be going on with me.
That's what's up, man. And can you, before we go, I want you to introduce your song, Ready, Aim, and we're going to play it for the people. And then after that, we're going to play Tell the World. And, you know, we definitely appreciate you calling in, man. We love the music. We're looking forward to the album, the EP. Whatever comes, we'll take it. We'll download it, put it in the iPod and everything.
Thanks a lot, man.
No problem, man. So if you can introduce that Ready, Aim, and we'll get you out of here.
All right. You ready?
Yeah.
What's good, people? This your boy, Molly Music, here. And what you're about to listen to right now is my new single, Ready, Aim. No matter what happens, you can't shoot me down. Fire. Let's get it.
I'm on an airplane, and the destination of the flight is to the other side. Guess I had to go there. Guess I had to come here, yeah. I know where I'm from, but now I'm headed where I'm going, right? But there are powers in the air, you can't see them. And they have rockets and machine guns, and they're firing on my plane. But I say fire, fire, fire. Ready, aim, fire. You can't shoot me down. Cause it's sideways, trying to take water to a dry place, trying to take hope where it ain't night, trying to take low to a high place. Wanna make the shooter put the gun down, so a mother gets to hold the sun now. Wanna make the lame man run again, make the blind man see the sun again. But all I hear is bang, bang, gag, gag. I don't think the pods really want that. Breathing down my neck, always on my back. Got the guns out, but I shoot fire. This rocket is too out of space. Guess I have to go there. Guess I have to come here, yeah. I'm from the earth, but I've been taken to another place. And there are powers even there, but you can see them.
I'm brand new. know one thing's true. I don't even really deserve to know you, but I'm a witness that you did this, and I'm brand new. So I'm ready to go, and I'ma tell the world what they need to know. I slave to myself, but you let me go. I tried getting high, but it left me low. You did what they could never do. You cleaned up my soul and gave me life. I'm so brand new, and that's all that matters. I ain't love you first, but